weeks. It was hard to tell how much the Empire's situation was shifting, but one thing was certain. Changes were happening. With the death of their ringleaders, the Imperial Liberation Front's campaign of terror was finally over. And in recognition of our actions in Ruhr and at Gorelia Fortress, all of us in Class 7 were invited to Valflame Palace. There, we were granted the honor of an audience with His Majesty the Emperor, Eugent III, along with Empress Priscilla, the mother of Princess Alvin and Crown Prince Cedric. But no sooner had we been thanked than we came face to face with the leaders of the factions that divided the nation. The heads of the four great houses who rule their vast provinces with absolute authority. And the Chancellor and his close ally, Governor Regnitz, who brought reforms to Heimdall and expanded the railways. Both sides were quick to offer us words of praise, but just as quickly turned to criticize each other's role in the crisis. Eventually, His Majesty was forced to step in and rebuke both sides, clearly disgusted by their behavior. As it stood, the terrorists' defeat made it difficult for their supposed supporters in the noble faction to act openly, while Crossbell's push for independence was causing enough of a stir over there to keep the reformists busy. With both sides tied up, it looked like the Empire was in for a long overdue respite from its perpetual conflict. We'd finally gotten all the details for our concert performance worked out, and Elliot announced that we'd be doing two songs, a duet between Machias and Eusis, and a solo by Emma. To no one's surprise, all three of them were quick to raise objections. But after Crow and Elliot explained their choices and how their master plan would win over the audience, the rest of the class was totally on board, leaving our new vocalists to resign themselves to the inevitable. Unfortunately, with the good times came some sad news as well. It turned out that Marquis Rogner was furious at Angelica for her part in what we did at the mine, and as a result, she was forced to leave the academy. Contrary to the official statement, her withdrawal was to be permanent. Before she left, she asked me if I'd look after the Orbital bike for her. At first, I didn't want to. It felt like I'd be accepting that she'd be gone. But after thinking it over, I finally agreed. With so much going on, we decided to take Prince Olivert up on his proposal of a brief vacation north in Ymir. It proved to be quite an eventful trip, and it really drove home just how much we'd come to mean to each other. I'd tell you all about it, but we'd be here for hours. Maybe another time. Anyway,
attention, please. It's another great day, perfect weather to start bringing all your great festival ideas to life. Some of you have been preparing since last month, and some even longer. I know you're all itching to get started. So without further ado, I hereby declare the first day of festival preparation begun. Time to start setting up! We have today and tomorrow. But try not to leave any work until tomorrow night unless you really have to. All right, everyone, let's do this and stay safe out there.
Thank you.
Let's give this a try. What even is this?
this is a big one!
Thank you.
Hello, Reen Schwarzer speaking.
Yo, it's me.
Oh, hey, Crow. Is something wrong? It's not like you to call out of the blue.
Well, we've run into a bit of a problem. Turns out our outfits for the concert will be arriving late. They said the earliest they can get them delivered is sometime tomorrow morning.
That's not great. I mean, it'll be hard to do tonight's dress rehearsal without the actual dress.
My thoughts exactly. But don't you worry, though. I'm just as crafty as I am handsome, so I've got a plan. Want to head out and pick them up for us in person?
Crow, I think the two of us need to go over the definition of plan sometime. You ordered them from a boutique in Heimdall, didn't you?
Yeah, someone over there is putting the finishing touches on them right now. They'll be done by this evening, so our whole delivery problem's solved if you just head over there. I do it myself, but I've got some stuff I need to get done.
Got it. I'll take care of it. I'll head to the station right now. Wouldn't want to miss the train on something this time sensitive.
Whoa there, the train? Come on, man. Don't tell me you forgot about Jellica's parting gift.
Oh. You're right. It'd probably be faster to get to Heimdall by bike than by train. Okay, bike it is. Besides, if I cut down on my travel time, I can put more work into the festival.
Even when I give you something cool to do, you find a way to make it dorky. Oh yeah, you should take someone with you too. You're bringing 11 outfits back here, and that's not exactly going to be easy on your own.
That's true. It'll be a lot easier with the sidecar too. Okay, leave it to me.
Cheers.
Okay, I guess I've got a little more wiggle room to help out around here. I'll head to the engineering club to ask George to lend me the bike once I'm done.
Thank you.
Everyone's probably got their hands full right now. I wouldn't want them to go out of their way on my account. There'll be a lot to carry, but I've got the sidecar, so I think I'll be all right.
Tell me, Reen, exactly what part of invite someone don't you understand? It really isn't that hard. And what would you have done if I wasn't free?
Sorry. I do appreciate you coming along, though.
Well, I gotta see how my babies came out. Besides, I'm sure Jellicoe would be thrilled to see me riding her bike, so I guess I can let you off the hook this time.
Crow, are you sure it was okay for you to come with me like this? It sounds like you had about a million people asking for your help.
Don't sweat it. I'm not that heavily involved with any of them, and I could finish up my bits just fine. This festival's all about the first years anyway. I know when to stand back and give the other folks their moment to shine.
That's surprisingly believable. And here I thought the instructors had caught wind of your gambling plans and you were trying to escape or something. Wait, seriously?
Eyes on the road, Reen. Eyes on the road.
Sorry to make you guys come all this way to pick these up. I think you'll be pretty happy with the way they turned out, though.
Fantastic! I can't wait to see them.
Thanks. Guess I owe you again this year.
After how hard you worked me last year, I was more than ready for this.
But even so, your concert made it all worth it. Let's hope these kids can do something that measures up. Oh yeah, one more thing. I made one of these outfits for you, too, just in case.
Oh, for me? You shouldn't have.
Crow, didn't you just give me a speech about how you were going to stay behind the scenes and let us shine?
Well, sure. I just figured that if I had a uniform, we'd feel like one big team. Yeah, that's a good enough excuse for now. Hate to snap you out of whatever this is, but we've got somewhere to be. If we don't get going, it'll be night by the time we're back at the dorms.
Yeah, sorry, I'm back. I just got distracted by a strange bird on that lamppost, that's all.
Strange, huh?
Yeah, I've never seen a bird that color before. It was a really deep blue, almost like lapis lazuli.
Huh, that does sound kind of strange. I wonder why it's hanging around in the city, though.
Who knows?
Oh, what do we have here?
Misty.
Oh?
It's been a while, hasn't it, Reen? Thanks for not using my real name. If people here in the capital were to overhear you, I'd be drowning in fans in no time flat.
Sure. Mum's the word. Fancy meeting you here, though. I assume you're here to shop?
You guessed it. This store does have a branch in Trista, but this one has a much better selection. What about you? What are you doing with those suitcases? Two buddies going off on an exciting adventure together, huh? Ah, to be a teenager again.
Sure are.
Since when? Ignore him. We're here on business, actually.
Wow, concert, huh? That sounds like a blast. I'd love to drop by the festival and see it myself. I might be able to go if I can free up a bit of space in my schedule.
It'd be great to have you. Although I can't imagine a professional like you would be terribly impressed.
Oh, don't be silly. Great music comes from the heart. Whoops, lost track of the time. I better get going. Well, bye for now. Be sure to tune in tomorrow.
Of course, I always do.
That was the Vita Clotilde, right? The opera singer? Whoa, you've got some friends in high places, Reen. So, do you just call her Misty to keep a low profile for your dates, or what?
For one thing, we're not dating. And more importantly...
Wow, really? She seems so laid back. She must be pretty amazing to handle two jobs at once.
Yeah, she's something all right. Wait a sec. Tomorrow's Friday, right? They only broadcast Advent time on Sundays.
Oh, yeah? Maybe she's on some other show this week.
Who knows? Well, I guess it doesn't really matter. We should head back to Trista. I'm sure everyone's waiting for us.
Definitely. We've got to get everyone into those outfits, the ladies especially. Then all that'll be left is surviving Commander Elliot's boot camp from hell.
Yeah, I'm sure it'll be fine. Hopefully.
Actually really nice.
Huh. They're a bit more revealing than I would have chosen, but at least the design itself is reasonably tasteful.
Yep, not bad.
And the black makes us look all classy, too.
Oh, what am I even doing in this getup?
Wow! That makes your boobies look even bigger!
Wow, you look stunning.
That's seriously hot.
Oh, I knew I shouldn't have trusted the boys.
I think it's perfect, and letting your hair down adds just the right amount of mystique. Nice work on the styling, Sharon.
Thank you, my lady. I think you all look beautiful.
Wow, you all look even better than I was hoping.
Well, you all look the part of dashing gentlemen yourselves.
It seems like you took your inspiration from the traditional dress of the imperial court.
You look like rejected princes from a children's book. But it kind of works.
I feel a little bad for you guys. Your uniforms don't have those little personal touches like ours do.
Well, considering the time we had to work with, we had to settle for all us guys just wearing the same thing.
No one's gonna care what the guys are wearing. It's better to bring out each girl's charms and let the boys just sort of fade into the background. That's called knowing your audience, boys and girls.
I see how it is.
We're all different heights and have different hair colors, so I think we're better off with a standardized look.
I'm no stranger to cuffs, epaulettes, and overdone embroidery.
But it looks preposterous to see you wearing such finery, even if it is just a costume.
Hey, I didn't ask for this! What sane man would want to dress like a noble? Besides, I hope you haven't forgotten that we'll be singing in these outfits together.
Sadly, despite my earnest attempts, I haven't.
All right, are you ready to practice the night away?
We've only got a day and a half left, and that's if you include today. No time to waste. And that's why none of us are leaving this building until we can do a perfect run-through of our whole set.
I don't think he's going to take no for an answer.
You're like a drill sergeant when it comes to music. I hope you're not starting to take after Nightheart.
We're not sleeping tonight, are we?
I'll be sure to bring you all a nourishing dinner later this evening.
That's not the problem here. Well, I suppose there's not much more we can do than buckle down and give it our best shot.
Fine. I suppose I'll just have to cast my shame to the wind and go through with it. It's not like I want to wear an outfit like this, but I might never get a chance again, so come on, Emma! Just grin and bear it!
Oh no! I think we broke Emma!
Maybe we ought to leave her be for a while.
Look at them all.
yammering on without a care in the world. I can't believe they actually convinced her to wear that outfit, too. Though, I suppose it does look rather bewitching. The conditions have all been met. Is this just the calm before the storm?